what this was for me was a great challenge, you know. Not only to portray just sort of one of those guys, but to portray a real guy. I think someone's in that building there.
Yeah, they always work late.
Yeah. It's that light right there.
Yeah. That's Joe the Butcher.
To portray a real guy. When I first read the book, I was really fascinated by this character, this guy who could do something like that, who could go 6 years undercover, live every day of his life, looking in the mirror, thinking, is today the day, you know, they're going to croak me.
Whack.
Whack being the proper word.
It's interesting you say that, because in a lot of the press over the years about you, part of your cult image is that you're that loner, that isolated, outcast, misfit, troublemaker, do drugs, do booze, that whole thing. But you've said many times you hate that typecast because it has nothing to do with who you really are. How have you been most misunderstood in your mind?
Well, all those things, I've been misrepresented. And, you know, I mean, people have assumed something based on something that they heard or something they read, and they've written about it and turned it into this fiction, and now that fiction is something that I have to carry around with me. Mm-hmm. And it's based on rumor, and it's based on lies, and it's not the worst thing in the world, but it's not, it's a bit of a drag to have to live with that.
Are you, I don't know, more sweeter, more vulnerable than they made you out to be, do you think?
I don't know about that. I mean, I wouldn't be a great judge of what I'm like. I just know that I'm not, I've never been a party boy or one of those guys who goes out and, you know, gets rip-roaring drunk and starts fights or gets in fights. You know, I mean, I've had a few episodes, let's say, you know, that have been unpleasant, but it's not like I instigated anything. I just had, you know, a couple of bad days.
Mm-hmm. You're known and respected as one of the few actors who's turned down big blockbuster hits, Legends of the Fall and so many others.
I wouldn't name them. I wouldn't name what they are, but...
But you never go for the money. You don't go for fame, for fame's sake. Is it that you view commercial success, fame, and the big bucks as contrary to your approach to an art as opposed to a business?
I probably... the thing with me is that I don't approach this like a business. And I, you know, I probably should. But I approach it much more as an art, if there's such a thing as art in movies, and I don't know that there is. But for me, it's important to do what you feel is right to do. You know, not based on what the thing is going to make at the box office or what it's going to do for this thing that they call career. You know, it's just to be true to yourself. And and it can be, you know, it could be a dangerous game, but I've been very lucky so far.
People have said the same thing about you, that like Brando, who you're often compared to, you have a way of saying a lot, but using no words, that just through your essence, we sense what you're feeling and what you're expressing. Is that taught or God-given?
I don't know. I'm not sure. I mean, I'm not aware of that thing, but... I don't know. Who knows?
Well, you are aware of it because you've said before that if you're conscious of what you're doing, you're not doing it right.
Yeah, that is true. I do believe that. I wouldn't know what to say about that. You know, I mean, I believe that I've been very lucky. That's all I know. You know, I've been very, very lucky in this. Job, you know.
Do you think you're talented?
I don't know if I'm talented. I wouldn't say I'm talented. I'm not the best judge of that, but I mean, I think that I am driven to do something. I have something to offer. I don't know what it is exactly yet, but I have something that I want to do, but I don't know if it has anything to do with talent. I don't know.